गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट मैथमेटिक्स स्टैंडर्ड 8। लेट अस सी द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, रैशनल एंड इरैशनल नंबर्स। दिस इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर बिकॉज इट इज यूज्ड फॉर 9th स्टैंडर्ड, 10th स्टैंडर्ड एंड अप टू व्हेन यू आर लर्निंग द मैथमेटिक्स। देयर एवरी टाइम वी मस्ट नो अबाउट द रैशनल एंड इरैशनल नंबर्स। वी आर फैमिलियर विद द नेचुरल नंबर्स, the whole numbers, integer numbers and the rational numbers. So let us see, these are the natural numbers. This is the set of the natural numbers. What we know about the set? We know and we can write n is equal to in curly bracket 1 2 3 4 5 dash 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 up to infinity, curly bracket complete. So this is our natural number set. Natural number set, it means the counting number which we say the natural numbers. These are the counting numbers 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. All these numbers are the natural numbers and we can say this is the set of the natural numbers. We must know about the numbers when we know about the rational and irrational numbers. This is the number 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the say the natural numbers. Then let us see the whole numbers. We already know about. Therefore, it is called as a recall. We know about it. What is this? So this is we are going to recalling about the numbers. But thereafter, if anyone know about what are the natural numbers, what are the whole numbers, we are going to learn before starting this chapter. So these are the natural numbers 1 2 3 4 5, the whole numbers. When natural number is added 0 or the number starts from 0 1 2 3 4 5 6, then this type number is called the whole numbers. When we add 0 in the natural numbers, it becomes whole number. So this is the natural number and this is the whole number. We generally know about this. So integer numbers, all natural numbers 0 and opposite number of the natural numbers is called the integer numbers. So this is the integer numbers. We know the numbers, these called the integers numbers, and set of the integer numbers can be written as, let us see, I is equal to the name integer number. So we write here I is equal to in curly bracket dash dash dash. It means in the left hand side there are the so many numbers, -3, -2, -1, -0, -2, -3, -... It means this is the set of the integer number. We can write this set as like this. This is the set of the integer numbers. So integer numbers means the 0 and all the natural numbers and opposite numbers of the natural numbers. We can say as like this. It means the natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 up to infinity. As like the opposite numbers of the 1 is -1. Opposite number of 2 is -2. Opposite number of 3 is -3. So this definition can be written as like this, I is equal to in curly bracket -1, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, ... up to infinity. So these are the integer numbers. We can write as like this. Now let us see the rational number. What are the rational numbers? Rational numbers is denoted by Q. It also be denoted by the Q. What is the set Q says? Q is equal to in curly bracket P upon Q, such that P upon Q, such that P comma Q belongs to capital N, and Q is not equal to 0. Q is not equal to 0. Q is not equal to 0. So write here 0 also. So this is also the definition of the rational numbers. Q is equal to P upon Q, such that in the 8th class we cannot understand this type of definition. It is going to understand in the next session or the 9th 10th class. So here is the rational numbers. What are the rational numbers? We just know about natural number is a subset of W. W is subset of I. I is subset of rational number, and all these numbers are subset of the real numbers. So in the rational number, let us see which numbers are come there. There is coming 0. It means from the whole number. It means every whole number is a rational number. Here comes 3. What means 3? Here is the 3. Here also 3. And here also 3. It means natural numbers are also rational number. Whole numbers are also rational numbers. And integer numbers are also rational numbers. Then after that, what is the we get the change here? Let us see. This is the 20 minus 25 upon 3. This is the fraction. Let us see. This is the fraction, minus 20 by 3. This is also the fraction. It means all the fractions are the rational numbers. All fractions are the rational numbers. It means every numbers we can write in the numerator and denominator P upon Q in the form. All these numbers are the rational numbers, where there is the condition that the Q is not equal to 0. Every number we can write in P upon Q form, then this number is called as a rational number. The rational numbers is also we can write in the decimal form. It means if we write 1 by 3, let us see, if we write 1 by 3, so this is the rational number. P is 1. It means P and Q are the integers number. P is 1 and Q is equal to 3. It is not equal to 0. Therefore 1 by 3 is a rational numbers. But when we write in the decimal form, we can write here 0.333. So this also the rational numbers. We can write the, in the decimal form as like this also. So 0.3333 up to infinity. So the number we are writing in the decimal form is a recurring or terminating, then that type of the number is called the rational number. So this is the basic definition. This is used for the scholarship, 5th scholarship 8, as well as NTS and NMS, where there is a competitive exam. There are the basic concept of the numbers. That is the natural numbers, whole numbers, integer numbers, rational number and the real number. So the definition of the rational numbers may be written here as the numbers of the form M upon N. Here they have been given M upon N. Generally we take the P upon P by Q. P means P and Q are the rational numbers, and Q is not equal to 0. This is the definition we are using the everywhere. This is the form of the Q set. So here is the using different variable M and N. The number of the form M by N are called the rational numbers. Here M and N are integers and N is not equal to 0. We have also seen that there are infinite rational numbers between any two rational numbers. It means in between we have seen also that there are infinite rational numbers between any two rational numbers. It means suppose 1 by 2 and 2 by 2, there are two rational numbers. Here 2 by 2 means also 1. In between these two rational numbers, there are infinite rational numbers. So this is the basic concepts of the numbers. It means the first number is a basic number is a natural numbers, which we can be say as the counting numbers also. These are the counting numbers are the natural numbers, and this is the counting numbers. Whole numbers, when we add the 0 in the rational natural number, we get the whole numbers. Then the integer numbers, here are the integer numbers. We can define as the 0 and all natural numbers and opposite numbers of the natural numbers are the integer numbers, and this is the rational numbers, the numbers which we can write in the numerator and denominator, like, and in the form of the decimal, are the rational numbers, and all these numbers are called as a real number. It means n is the subset of w, w is the subset of I, and I is the subset of r. So we see this is the recall of the previous years, so we are going to learn about this. Let us see the second section of this topic, to show rational numbers on a number line. We know the number line. This is the number line. We have been already in the our textbook. This is the number line. Let us understand what is the number, how we can show the rational numbers on the number line. This is the number line. Number line indicated as a, let us see here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and here also minus 4, minus 5 at the infinity. We can be say that at the infinity. Let us see how to show 7 by 3, 2 and minus 2 by 3. So we are going to show these numbers on the number line. Let us see how we can solve this example. Here is a 7 by 3. Let us see what is the first number 7 by 3. It means when what is the denominator? Let us see. Denominator is a 3. Then here also, what is the denominator? Here also the denominator 3. Let us see where there is a denominator 3, or which number make the same part of the 1 centimeter. So this is the 0 and this is the 1. So make a equal part. How many equal parts? 3 equal parts. What we are going to show? 7 by 3. What is the denominator? 3. So make the 3 equal part from 0 to 1. So let us see here 1, 2. When we cut into 2 part, it becomes 3 equal parts. This is the 1. It means if there is the 1 centimeter, we can use the 3.3 millimeter as like this. So every part is converted into 3 basic parts. 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. So there are converted into 3 basic parts. 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3, as like this. We are going to see how we can show the on this number line. Let us see if we make the 3 equal parts, then what is the value of first part? From this we can understand very well, this is the first part, so value of this part becomes 1 by 3. What is the value of second part? 2 by 3, they have been given. And what is the value of third part? 3 by 3. So 3 by 3 means also 1. We can understand very well that 3 by 3 is equal to 1, so this value becomes 1. So this value is a 1 by 3. This value is a 1 by 3. This is the value 2 by 3, 3 by 3, 4 by 3, 5 by 3, 6 by 3, and this is the 7 by 3. So we are going to show the first value 7 by 3 as like this. So what is the second value? 2. So 2 is the common value, and we can be show this 2 as like this. And what is the minus 2 by 3? If there is the minus, then take the left side of the number line. So 1 by 3 and 2 by 3. So this is the left side, therefore we have given the negative sign. So this is the minus 2 by 3. So we can show the number 2 on the number line. Then 7 by 3 is equal to 7 multiple by 1 by 3. Therefore, so they have been showing how we can show the numbers. When we are showing the numbers, we must give the coordinate. We say it as a coordinate. So this is the coordinate, and we can show the O. O is the coordinate we can use for this. So this is our O coordinate, A, B, C, D. name of the coordinate. So we must give the name for the number lines. Here is not given the names. So let us see the practice set 1.1. In the practice set 1.1, what is the first question? Show the following numbers on a number line. Draw a separate number line for each the example. It means they have been said that this is the first example, this is the second example, this is the third example. We again show that this is the first example, this is the second example, this is the third example, and this is the fourth example. They have been given due to that when we are arranging these numbers on the number line, that all these numbers have here is the 2 denominator, here is the 5 denominator, here is 8 denominator, and here is the 10 denominators. What is useful for us this? Let us see. If we draw a number line, the number line is as like this. This is our points. Let us see. Here are the points. 0. Here is 1. We are going to draw it approximately, but you can understand. Take an exact 0 1 0 1 2 3 4 5 as like this. We can -1 -2 -3 -4 and -5. So what is our first example? We can write here also what is the value. I'm going to draw it by the mouse, so it is not the clear as like seen. Or we can write here using this. This is the 1, this is the 2, this is the 3 4 5. So when we are going to write the negative numbers, here is not the option of the negative numbers. So let us see, we can write from by the mouse. This is the 0, negative 1, negative 2. So by drawing the mouse, this is so difficult to draw. But you can understand that what I am going to write down here. When you draw in your notebook, use pencils and a scale to measure the values. So this is the 0. Suppose this is not like seeing that the 0, but this is the 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So what is the first value? 3 by 2. It means what we can be understand that what is the denominator here? Denominator is a 2. So how many parts we are going to make make of the 1 centimeter? 2 parts. And how it becomes? Let us divide it by 2. It means 5 millimeter. Let us draw it. This is the 5 millimeter. This is the 5 millimeter. It means every centimeters we make the 2 parts. So what is the value of first part? 1 by 2. So this is the part of 1 by 2. What is the second part? 2 by 2. It means 1. We can check this by using this. This is the 2 by 2. It means 1. Here is the 3 by 2. So this is our the first answer. 3 by 2. We just circle it when we draw in our notebook and give any name. So we are going to give the name A. So this is our answer. So this is our answer. So we are giving the point and just circle the pencil and give the name of the coordinate. Then 5 by 2. What is become here? 1 by 2, 2 by 2, 3 by 2, 4 by 2, and here 5 by 2. Then there is no need to draw every coordinate. And this. So what we can say here? 1 by 2, 2 by 2, 3 by 2, 4 by 2, and here is the 5 by 2. So this is the value of B, 5 by 2. So give this value and only write this value. There is no need to draw or write the value of 1 by 2 such like and 2 by 2. We can write only the proper value which we have been answered. So we can write as like this number lines. Then what is the second question? Observe the number line and answer the questions. Let us see how we can answer the question. which number is indicated by point B. Let us go on the point B. First of all, what we are going to, let us see what is the portions or parts of the 1 centimeter. 1, 2, 3. It means this is the first part, second, third and fourth part. This means the value of first point is 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4 and 4 by 4. It means 1. Every time we can remember here, the value of 1 becomes minus 4 by 4. So this is become minus 1. So we are calculating the right answers. Then here is the 5 by 4, 6 by 4, 7 by 4, 8 by 4, 9 by 4 and 10 by 4. So this is the left side's value. Therefore, what is our the first answer? Minus 10 upon 4. So this is the value of B. So we can write easily the value of B. So this is the simple way to find out the value of B. Then which point indicates the 1 and 3 by 4? 1 and 3 by 4. It means 1 is the whole number here and 3 by 4. It means out of 4 the third number. This is the 1 fraction, whole numbers, then 3, third part, 1, 2, 3. So this is, we get C. So the value of the second examples is 3. So this is our second example value. Then state whether the statement the point D denotes the number 5 by 2 is true or false. Is denote D is 5 by 2. What is the value of 5 by 2? Let us see, 2.5. We can fractionize or get in the decimal form. What we get? 5 by 2 is equal to 5 by 2, it is equal to 2.5. So is the value of D is 2.5? Let us see. Here is the 2 and here is the 3. So this is the middle value. It means this is the 2.5. So this is the right example. So students, today we learn about the basic of the number lines, whole numbers and integer numbers, as well as how to show the numbers on the number line and draw the separate line, how we can draw the separate line. Please see the whole video, and if you do not subscribe this channel, please subscribe the channel, like the channel and share you who want to loves and who are the study in the 8th standard. This is useful, the topic for the scholarship also, NTS, MTS or any competitive exams. So please like and subscribe the channel. Thank you.